Hello friends, dear chairman, ladies and gentlemen, I, Mohan-l-Verma from Department of Applied Physics, Sri Shankaracharya Technical Campus, Junwani Philai, India, welcome you all in my presentation. The title of my presentation is Breaking Energy and Mechanical Strength of Kevlar 29. Before starting the presentation, I would like to thank my co-workers Harsha Verma, Dr. B.K. Shoro, and Dr. Jiten Chauhan, along with the management of my institution to help directly and indirectly to complete this work. In this conference, this paper has been included as poster, which is some categorized usually in form of abstract, introduction, methodology, resultant discussion, then conclusion, and some references. So the first part in abstract, this is actually a first principle based study which is performed for the analysis of mechanical strength of Kevlar 29. This is very wonderful material. Initially, the structure is optimized by density functional theory, which is implemented in SISTA. This is a quantum chemistry-based software. The bond strength is investigated by the displacement of central nitrogen atom along X, Y, and Z direction respectively. The structure properties analysis provides this material as having symmetric nature. Larger bond breaking energy is observed during compression along Z direction, and the lower energy is observed during elongation. It is insulator as its forbidden energy gap is measured, and it is also shown that when the material is compressed, the forbidden energy gap increased. And this energy gap reduces when reduces gradually during elongation. We have also performed its coup analysis, which reveals the higher strength of antibonding orbitals. Higher strength stress is required along Z axis to produce the strain and is smaller along Y axis. Therefore, Kevlar 29 is observed mechanically stronger along its Z axis and weaker along Y axis. One can say this Z axis is longitudinal because it is along its length, and X and Y axis is in a transverse direction. So one can say this Kevlar 29 is mechanically stronger in along its longitudinal direction, and in its transverse direction it is slightly weaker. Few keywords here we have shown. Now the introduction part is concentrated mainly on its mainly on this material. So in this study, the systematic features, synthetic features of fiber, this Kevlar, which is chemically also known as PPTA, this is very important, and it is formed by combining these two chemicals. It is highly crystalline polyaramide fiber with exceptionally high strength and remarkable thermal stability. And because of this property, this is widely used in stress bearing applications such as bulletproof body armor, shielding for sport equipments, and fiber reinforcement polymer composites in aerospace industry. Kevlar fiber has also been extensively used in the field of aerospace, military, marine, and mountain engineering, etc. And this is mainly because of its good mechanical properties, thermal stability, and energy absorption properties. Kevlar is a good example of an elastic polymer fiber with high elastic modulus, high breaking stress, and low breaking strain. It is several times stronger than steel. This is a purely theoretical study which is performed to investigate the breaking energy and mechanical strength of Kevlar 29. and in which we have taken the help of density functional theory, which is implemented in the sister software. As far as the methodology is concerned, we have used sister, the quantum chemistry based software, and as for the exchange correlation potential, we have used this generalized gradient approximation GGA, and core electrons are modeled with TM norm conserving pseudo potential. Before further study, the material structure is relaxed, it is optimized, geometrically optimized up to the force acting in all components of each atoms, which are smaller than 0.01 electron volt for angstrom. For optimization of system, we have used four steps method, and for which we have developed some scripts in our laboratory. For the detail of this optimization process, one can go through my YouTube channel, and simply you can search by using my name Mohan L. Verma in YouTube search, then you can get that title of channel, and that is actually for beginners. So you can get how we actually optimize the structure systematically before further study. This is the equilibrium configuration of this material, and this central nitrogen is shown here in the bond length. It is measured from molden, and that is 1.25 angstrom, and it is 1.38 angstrom, and this is 1.42 angstrom, and this is comparable to experimental bond length, as well as one can compare this bond length with other similar substances also. And other three fixtures are also here. In this case, this nitrogen, the central atom, is displaced along x-axis here, along this is positive x-axis as well as negative x-axis, and this is along positive and negative y-axis, and this is along its length, obviously along z-axis. So here this xyz represent the breaking of a structure during the variation of the central atoms n positioning along xyz axis respectively. And there is higher compression energy required to, this is some result shown here, there is higher compression energy required to break the bond along z axis, and this is the data, 194.584 electron volt, and smaller along y axis. So along its length the energy is higher, and along its transverse direction it's very compared to this it is smaller. During elongation of the bond, there is a larger energy required along x axis, that is 18.703 electron volt, and along its length it's 1.219 electron volt. And this is comparable to our previous work. We have before this study we have performed similar work in PO based polymer, which has been recently published in International Journal of Ionics. And that is also a very good work, and widely accepted by scientific community. By applying strain, this band gap is increased. There is a larger variation along x-axis, and few energy states are also found in the forbidden inner region, just below and just at higher energy states of Fermi level. Now, sorry for interruption during this sliding this poster. So this reduction of crystallinity and increase in amorphicity of this. Now this table number first, which shows the bond breaking energy, and this bond breaking means CN bond breaking energy, and this is along x-axis, so y-axis and z-axis, and obviously along z-axis this is higher, and as I have mentioned earlier also, and this is during elongation, this is higher in the case of x-axis, and lower, very lower in the case of this. And with the help of this dust plot, this is the dust plot, the application of strain. Some variation in Fermi energy level is also observed. This is for equilibrium traveler 29 and along x-axis. Y-axis, very slight variation is observed in all direction, but with compared to this, there is some variation is observed. And forbidden energy gap, this is also increasing. In the case of z-axis, it's a 4.0, and slight variation is observed in forbidden energy gap. The dust plot, and here this Fermi energy level in this dust plot, the Fermi energy level is shifted to zero. So by comparing the forbidden energy gaps obtained in compression along the solid bond, it is observed that the strain produced in compression energy gap is little larger than for the elongation, and it is decreased gradually for the further elongation and for higher values of strain. We have also performed, as I have mentioned earlier, the Coupe analysis. This is crystal orbital overlap population, and this gives more insight view of bonding characteristic of system. So this is the Coupe plot, where this y-axis shows the bonding and anti-bonding nature of anti-bonding orbitals. The upper part is bonding and the lower part is antibonding. The first part is actually the Coupe plot of C and OS suborbitals, and here C and this is carbon and oxygen, and this is for carbon and nitrogen, this is for carbon-carbon bonds, and this is in between elements carbon-carbon and carbon-nitrogen and carbon-oxygen bonding and antibonding. So by observing this plot, we can say we have the resultant strength of anti-bonding orbitals than bonding orbitals, and it reduces the crystallinity of Kevlar 29 and increases its amorphicity. Now tensile strength is calculating by using this formula, where this sigma is tensile strength is the total energy, and this ohm, it is the volume at that particular strength epsilon. And for detailed calculation of this, we have applied stress along x, y and z direction, and this is the plot for some specific values. It is along x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. Now we have observed such a variation. I think plot is somewhere here. This is the plot, total energy system. This is the plot, and this is equilibrium position, and it's the left hand side, so it's a compression, and the right hand side, so it's a elongation. So and we have taken few points to calculate tensile strength by using that shown formula. So what we have observed, the negative values of strain and tensile strength are representing the compression, and positive values for elongation of C and bond, especially of this Kevlar 20. The results of this is shown in this, and the results of compression are approximately equal to the experimental values. This is the reference along y-axis and z-axis. Unfortunately, there is no data obtained along z-axis, means along the length of this tensile. For elongation, the calculated values along x-axis are nearly equal to experimental values, but y-axis it's too smaller, and this higher tensile strength is required during elongation of bond than compression. It is found 10 times higher along x-axis and 2-3 times along y-axis. Along z-axis, higher tensile strength is required for compression than the first values of strength of elongation, and approximately equal for the stress values. So the total energy of system is increased during compression as well as for the elongation of elongation along all axes, as observed in this plot. And this is the plot in between stress and strain. To produce the same strain, the ratio of increase in ramp energy is higher along z axis and lower along y axis. A linear relation between stress and strain for all axes to produce same region, higher stress is required to apply along z axis and smaller along y axis. So one can say the Kevlar 29 is mechanically stronger along its z axis and weaker along y axis. This is also observed in this plot between stress and strain. So as conclusion, we can say this is actually the structural properties analysis of Kevlar 29, and the structural properties analysis exhibits that the Kevlar 29 has a symmetric nature. There is higher bond breaking energy required along z axis in compression of CN bonds, and lower energy is required in elongation. The dust plot explains the insulating nature and to change in its amorphicity of K29 related to stress. At equilibrium condition, while applying strain, the forbidden energy gap increases and it's larger along x-axis. During compression, the forbidden energy gap is little larger than its value obtained for elongation. For further increasing stress in elongation, the energy gap decreases gradually. Coupe analysis gives the resultant strength of anti-bonding orbitals than bonding orbital, which explains the reduction in crystallinity and increases in amorphicity. To produce same stress, the system requires higher energy along z axis and a smaller along y axis. So finally, the higher stress is required for applying along z axis to produce the same strain and a smaller along y axis. So finally, we can say the K29 is mechanically stronger along its length. One can say it's along that is along z axis and weaker along y axis. These are few references we have used, and this is our previous work published in Ionics, and this is for solid polymer electrolyte system PU5 lithium 04. Thank you very much.